The idea to do a Cannonball Adderley tribute record really began when I went to a club to see Tom Scott performing, and he was playing a tune called Sack of Woe, was one of Cannonball's hits from years ago, and there was such a connection between Tom and this music, and that's where the idea began to, wouldn't it be great to put an all-star band together and revisit this material that I've loved since I was a kid. From the beginning, when Tom and I first started talking about making this record, we knew we wanted Nancy Wilson to appear on it. And when she agreed to do it, we really felt like the entire project had come together. We had the musicians cast, but Nancy agreeing to participate was the icing on the cake. So is love.
It came about, Greg wanted to do a tribute to Cannonball. He and Tom started talking about it. Well, if you're going to do that, Nancy Wilson would be obvious because I'm still here. So that was easy. They wanted to know if I would be willing to do it. Of course I would be willing to do it. Are you kidding? You're doing a tribute to Cannon? Yeah, I'm there. Love. This is the way we used to do it. Walk in, bam, hit it, and it's over, it's done. It's a dream, you know, to have these musicians together and to deal with Cannonball Adderley. You know, it's like, whoa, thank you.
We wanted to assemble an all-star group of musicians that really had this material in their musical DNA. Terrence Blanchard, George Duke, who used to work with Cannonball Adderley, Marcus Miller, Steve Gadd made up the core band. And this choice of musicians, Tom and I really felt would really make this period of Cannon's music come alive and contemporize it to bring it into the 21st century.
Look at this group of gentlemen who are the finest of their time and have been for some time, and nobody seems to be touching them. This is cream of the crop.
Darling, please save your love for me. You may have fun with the crowd, but the crying out loud. Darling, please.